Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Alone, and I am on my Old School RuneScape normal account, and not an Iron Man. The last videos that I made on Old School RuneScape was like 2.5 years ago, and it was on an Iron Man account, so you probably, if you've been subscribed since then, waiting in just hoping for me to make Old School RuneScape videos or anything like that, you probably don't remember anything about this account, so I'm just going to quickly update you guys on what it's like. So it's 34 quest points. I have done almost no quests at all. Like, I've only done some essential ones, like, I don't know, Rune Mysteries, that's like super simple, and then Animal Magnetism. I've done the Lost City that you can see I'm in now, but otherwise I don't really think I've done any major quests, so it's not really much to look into. Now, these are my stats. I don't really have that good skilling stats at all, like 62 cooking is like my highest one. I guess Slayer is counted more as a combat stat anyways, but my combat stats overall are okay. Like, my strength is 64, which is not that great, but I'm currently working on 75 attack, so I can use my Abyssal Whip, and I'm working almost primarily on that on Slayer because I do already have the whip. So my bank is 14 mil right now, so it's actually not that bad. I mean, compared to some other players, yeah, it's not that much, but it's a decent start, you know, so I'm not too fussed about that. I have the Void set, actually. I think I have the full set. I don't remember exactly, but I think I do because I did some Sulra back when I played on this account, and I think I got the full set for that. And then also I have full Arims, I think. And I think full Carrels, but it seems to be broken right now. And this is, you can see this, if you play Old School RuneScape, this is like a typical tab for Sulra killing. So this is my Slayer tab. It's extremely small, but I am planning on trying to get this to a decent amount of value in the near future. I have a clue scroll in my inventory, a hard one that I got from Slayer pretty recently. I killed some, I think it was Turoths that I killed, and I got that. So I'm going to be doing that, and I'm also going to be picking up a new Slayer task now. So that's pretty much where I'm at with my account, and let's get into it. Oh, and by the way, this is my current equipment. I have a Dragon Chain body, I have a Slayer helmet, which is really nice that I have. I actually really am happy that I already have the Slayer helmet, and I have the Fire Cape as well. I did that back in the day. So anyways, let's get an assignment, see what we get. 10 Wall Beasts. That actually seems terrible. I'm just going to skip that. I don't even know how to do that, I'm not gonna lie. But I have some points, so it's not that bad. Actually, confirm, get a new task. And 149 Hellhounds. That's pretty good, actually. I think they're pretty good for hard clue scrolls as well. But I'm going to complete this hard clue, and I'll get back to you guys with the reward. As I mentioned, I haven't really done that many quests on this account, and I need to wear a rune plate body for this, and I'm 88 combat, and I still haven't completed Dragon Slayer on this account. So you know what? I'm just gonna do it now. Alright, there we go. That's Dragon Slayer done, and I get some decent experience for it as well. And, well, it was a quest that I had to get done anyways, because, come on, who hasn't done Dragon Slayer at, like, level 88? So, yeah, let's see if I got any levels as well. Yeah, 65 strength, and that's about it. So let's do the clue step. Actually, a really good reason to doing clue scrolls is I'm forced to do quests. I have to go to this place, which requires me to use a fairy ring, and I need to do Nature Spirit, Fairy Tale Part 1, and I need to start Fairy Tale Part 2. So I have to do that right now, so I need to do two quests. Let's get on it. Extremely easy quest. It's like one of the easiest quests in the game. Nature Spirit done. I got some nice experience. Let's see if I got any levels for that. Probably not, but it might be skills that I have like really low levels in. Apparently not. No levels. Let's do Fairy Tales. And that's a Fairy Tale Part 1 completed, Growing Pains. It was extremely easy, and I got 3.5k farming experience for that, which is kind of interesting, because I was 1 farming before this, so let's see what level I got from that. 17, so from 1 to 17, that's pretty nice. So I completed the step that I had to use the Fairy Ring for, but the next step I got also required the Fairy Ring, so that's pretty good. 2 steps in a row that I just got from 1 quest. So this could be one of the last steps, so I'm going to be able to do this one, and no quests required, and I can just get these items. Well, I can either pay this amount of money and just teleport there, or I can do Gertrude's Cat, or whatever that quest is called, and then also just only start Iklarin's Little Helper quest, and I will just be able to walk in there, so I'm going to do that. Alright, that's the quest completed, extremely easy, and let's just do the Iklarin's Little Helper, just the beginning of it, so I can actually enter the city. Alright, that's everything completed, and I get the casket, so let's see what the reward finally is. Let's open this and see what we get. And that is a Gothic Stole Rune Plate Legs. Okay, that's 64k worth, so that's actually terrible. Okay, well that was fast, another hard clue scroll after like, what, 15 kills maybe? I don't know, let's see if we can do these steps. So apparently, even for the first step for this clue, I have to do two quests, the dig site and bone voyage, and also I have to get 100 museum kudos. And honestly, two quests for just the first step is not really that interesting to me. So I'm just going to drop it, and I'm going to try to get a new one that I can actually do the first step of, or if it's just a small requirement for the first step. Okay, well, I guess that proves my point. I can drop clue scrolls here probably pretty frequently if I can't do the first step. So it took me like, what? I don't know. Okay, the clue scroll is still on the ground. That's how long it took for me to get another one. Okay, this is a fairy ring one, so I can definitely do this. Oh, well, that's interesting. I got I think this is step number 4 or 3, where I have to wear a crozier, and I am 55 prayer, and you need 60 to be able to equip this. So I will be getting 60 prayer. I'm gonna buy some dragon bones and go to someone else's house, pray on their altar, and I'll get back to you guys when I'm 60. All right, easy. 60 prayer, there we go. Let's complete the clue step. Now the step was in the wilderness, so I just got the casket and left, so let's see what the casket actually is going to give me. And that is worth 32k, so that's even worse than the past one. Unlucky. Taking a break from RS for like 2.5 years really can make you forget things. Abyssal Whip is actually 70 attack. Yeah. I actually forgot that, and the people who actually play OSRS is probably really mad at me right now that I'm like, oh, I'm gonna get 75 so I can use Abyssal Whip. Yeah, I don't know why I thought that. It might be because you need 85 Slayer to be able to kill them, the Abyssal Demons, that I correlated it with like 75 attack or something for the whip. I don't remember actually why, but yeah, that's kind of awkward. Now I can use the whip at least, or I've been able to use it, so I'm just going to start using that instead. Now this is actually really good. I'm a huge PVM fan, that's primarily what I prefer to do. I love to do Slayer, I love to do bossing and all that kind of stuff. And the clue scroll step that I have right now is to go into Shiloh Village, and I actually haven't done that quest, and I have to do, let's see if it's right here, Shiloh Village, I have to do Jungle Potion as well, but that's very easy, and I have all the requirements otherwise. I'm going to do Jungle Potion and Shiloh Village, and the good thing about this is I will complete the clue scroll step, and I also will unlock the Slayer Master in there, but I'm only 90 combat, or almost 90 combat, so I have another goal to go for, so I can do Slayer and, you know, get all the drops and experience from that, and get to 100 combat as my next goal. Okay, so that's Jungle Potion completed. Extremely easy. Did I get any levels? Yes, I did. 21 Herb Lore from 20. And I'm going to do Shiloh Village now. Alright, so that's the Shiloh Village quest completed. Took me like 30 minutes or something like that to do, so it was not that bad. And I can now complete the clue scroll. And if there's no further steps... Okay, I just fell. That's great. Anyways, if there's no further steps where I need a requirement, I'll just be back in the next clip with the reward. Okay, dude, look at this. I have to go to Mostly Harmless. Well, that is Cabin Fever as a requirement to get there. So that's quite hefty, because look at what I need to do. I need to get 50 smithing, which is huge on its own because I'm 4 smithing. And then I need to do Rum Deal and Pirate's Treasure. But there is another quest I also have to do, or I want to do rather, which is the, The Knight's Sword quest. So I need to get 10 mining first as well, because this is going to give me like... from 4 to maybe 30 smithing or 29, something like that. So that's going to save me some of the leveling on smithing at least, and it's another quest that I can get out of the way. So yeah, this is the reason why I wanted to complete this quest. The Knight's Sword is now done, and I am level 29 smithing, very close to 30. So that's a good start, but I'm going to check the other quest if I need any other requirements. I'm going to see if I can do the Rum Deal. Okay, guys, okay. 40 farming and 50 fishing. Yeah, I'm gonna do this, by the way, but I'm going to do it in the next video, because I'm going to start it with me getting 50 fishing or something like that, because it's going to take too long otherwise, but I am 1 fishing. Yeah, I'm 1. So I'm going to have to go all the way from 1 to 50 fishing, and then from 17 to 40 farming, which I honestly think is going to be more annoying, 17 farming to 40 farming, than 50 fishing from 1, because I think fishing is okay, you can AFK it really nicely, but when you're low farming, it's just so annoying. But anyways, that's going to do it for this video. In the next one, I'll definitely complete Cabin Fever and way more than that. I thank you guys for watching so much, and I hope it was enjoyable. I'm still a bit rusty in the game, of course, because I just came back, so I'm going to be making mistakes and all that, and if you have any advice for me, please leave them in the comment section below. I will read all of it. So anyways, again, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one, guys. Take care.